Hey everyone, I am Kyle, and in today's video, I am here to simplify the process of applying for Social Security retirement benefits. Whether you're applying for yourself or a loved one, this guide will walk you through everything you need to know to get started. So, first thing that you want to do is go into ssa.gov on your browser, and then I'm going to tell you the ways to apply. So, there are three ways. Number one is by phone. Number two is at your local Social Security office. And number three would be online, which is what we'll be doing and the most convenient option. So for online applications, you need to create a My Social Security account here at ssa.gov. You just simply want to scroll down and click here on Learn About Your Account. I'm going to tell you what you would need. So when applying, make sure to have this on hand. So number one would be your personal details. So this would be the date, place of birth, and your Social Security number. And then your marital history, including current and previous marriages. And then next would be the children's info. So even if they are adults, you will still need them. And then next would be the work history. So employment details for the past 2 years, plus W-2s or tax returns if self-employed. And then you would also need your banking details, account and routing numbers for direct deposits, as payments must be electronic. And lastly would be the veteran status, so service dates and papers if applicable. So if you're a veteran and served before 2002, you might qualify for special earning credits. So now let me tell you about the important timelines. You can apply up to 4 months before you want benefits to start, giving Social Security time to process your claim. And then next would be the special cases. So for the spousal benefits, the same application process applies if you're claiming benefits based on your spouse's work history. And then next would be the survivor benefits. This can only be applied for by phone or in person and require additional documents like the deceased Social Security number and a death certificate. So I hope this guide makes applying for Social Security benefits less overwhelming. If you have questions, let us know in the comments and we'll consider them for future videos. So yeah, that is basically it for this video. I hope to help you in getting your Social Security more simpler. I hope this video helped you out. Thank you for watching.